In this video, I'll show you how to tackle logarithm-style questions without a calculator, as it may show up on your MCAT. Logs are tricky, and unlike other questions that you can fall back on the long mathematical process like multiplication, division, addition, subtraction, with logs, you either know it or you don't. So I want to make sure that if you're asked to calculate anything like a pH or a pKa on your MCAT, you know what to do and you know how to do it quickly and confidently. And the good news is that on the MCAT, when you're asked to solve a log type question, the answer choices will be so far apart that if you quickly get a value that is close enough, you're good enough, you have the answer, and you're able to move on and devote more time to your next question. You may find yourself faced with a question that reads, find the pH of a 2.3 times 10 to the minus 4 molar solution of NaOH. The chemistry portion of this question will be tackled in my chem videos at layitforsci.com/chemistry, but for now let's focus on the math. To find the pH of a solution, we first have to see the ion concentration given. Since we're given an NaOH or OH minus concentration, we'll go from the OH minus concentration to the pOH, and from there we'll get to the pH, because pH plus pOH is 14. But the difficult part is going from the OH minus concentration to the pOH. We'll use the following formula. pOH is equal to negative log of the OH minus concentration, which in this question is negative log 2.3 times 10 to the minus 4. Great, I have the setup, but I don't have a calculator. How do I proceed? So how do we find the negative log of this value? Let's focus on the trick first, and then we'll come back to solve this question. Here's what you have to know about logs on the MCAT. When given log of a number, you're really given log base 10. And this tells you 10 to the what power is equal to this number. Don't worry, we're not going through the long, tedious solving of logs. Instead, we'll understand what's going on, then I'll show you a quick shortcut. This is easy for simple questions. For example, given log of 100, ask yourself, 10 raised to what power is equal to 100? Since 10 times 10, or 10 squared, is 100, the answer is 2. What about the log of 1,000? 10 to the what power is equal to 1,000? Well, 10 times 10 times 10, or 10 to the third, equals 1,000, and so the answer is 3. Now what about the negative logs? While negative logs appear to be more difficult, it's actually the same thing with a negative before the power. So for example, negative log of 0.1 is equal to 1, because 1 times 10 to the minus 1 is equal to 0.1. Another way to think of this is turn this into scientific notation. 0.1 is really 1 times 10 to the minus 1, so we already have 10 raised to a power of a negative number. And here's the trick. When your number is written out in scientific notation, you have 10 to the negative number. Just circle that number, and that is your answer. Let's try this shortcut again. Say you're told negative log of 1 times 10 to the minus 4. We have 1 times 10 to a negative power. Circle that power, and the answer is 4. What about negative log of 1 times 10 to the minus 11? Again, 10 to the negative number, circle that number, and the answer is 11. Let's apply this to something you already know. A neutral solution at room temperature will have a pH at 7. This solution will also have an equivalent H plus and OH minus concentration, each equaling 1 times 10 to the minus 7. So let's prove this mathematically. The pH is equal to negative log the H plus concentration, which is equal to negative log 1 times 10 to the minus 7. We have our value set up as 1 times 10 to a negative power. Grab that power, and the answer is 7. But what if we don't have 1 times 10 to the power, and instead have 2.3 times 10 to a power, such as the example given? This is where we're going to apply additional tricks and simplification, keeping in mind that we only need an answer that is close enough. Let's start with something simple. Say we're trying to solve the negative log of 4.5 times 10 to the minus 3. First, we want to get a ballpark, but we need this expression to be set up as 1 times 10 to a negative power. So I want to find the in-between values by taking 4.5, rounding it down to 1, and up to 10, because this way my number will start with a 1. If I round it down to 1, I get 1 times 10 to the minus 3, and if I round it up to 10, I get 10 times 10 to the minus 3. But 10 times 10 to a power is not in proper scientific notation, so we want to divide the 10 by 10, giving me 1, and then multiply the exponent by 10, or raise it by 1 power, giving me times 10 to the minus 2. 10 times 10 to the minus 3 is the same thing as saying 1 times 10 to the minus 2. Now I can solve for the negative logs. 1 times 10 to the minus 3 gives me 3. 1 times 10 to the minus 2 gives me 2. And so if this was an H plus concentration, my pH would be somewhere between 2 and 3. But this is where you want to be careful. 4.5 seems like the halfway between, let's say, 4 and 5, but it's not going to be the halfway between my pHs. This is where you have to make a decision. Check your MCAT choices. If you see only one value between the pH of 2 and 3, pick that answer and save your time. But if you have multiple values and you need to zero in a little more, we can take this trick a step further. What you want to understand moving forward is that a logarithmic scale is going to go 10 to 100 to 1,000, so we start small and then it skyrockets. So the numbers are going to follow a similar pattern. In addition to knowing the values between 1 and 10, it helps to recognize, if not memorize, what the negative log values will be if your coefficient is a 3, a 5, a 7, or an 8, because then you can always extrapolate the numbers in between. I'll show you the calculator values, and then I'll show you the numbers that you want to study. The negative log of 1 times 10 to the minus 3 is 3. We already know that. But as we increase from 1 times 10 to the minus 3 all the way to 10 times 10 to the minus 3, we're moving closer and closer to 2. So as your coefficient goes up, your pH, your pKa, or the number that we derive is going to go down. 3 times 10 to the minus 3 on the calculator is equal to 2.53. What I want you to recognize is 3 times any power is going to give me a number 0.5. 5 times 10 to the minus 3 on the calculator is 2.3, so recognize that if we have a 5, we get a number 0.3. 8 times 10 to the minus 3 is equal to 2.1, so any number starting with an 8 will be a number 0.1. And obviously, if we add in 10 times 10 to the minus 3, which is the same thing as saying 1 times 10 to the minus 2, our answer is going to be 2. So here's the pattern to recognize. 3 starts with a 5, that's like your halfway point, and then we go down to 3, down to 1, and we're at the lower number. In other words, for the quicker version, if you're given 5 times 10 to the minus 3, we recognize the number is near 3, but because it's a 5 and not a 1, we have to go down, and the answer will be 2 point something. In this case, 2.3. So let's go back to our initial example. We're trying to solve 2.3 times 10 to the minus 4. First, we want to find the range, and the range will be, this is my lowest number because I round 2.3 down to 1. 1 times 10 to the minus 4 is 4. Rounding it up to 10, 2.3 becomes 10 times 10 to the minus 4, or 1 times 10 to the minus 3, giving me 3. So we know the pOH is going to be between 3 and 4. Remember the trick when we used 3 times 10 to the minus 3 and it was 2.53? In this case, 2.3 is very close to 3, so the answer should be very close to 0.5, but we have to take the smaller number. It won't be 4.5, it'll be something like 3.5 because we know our pOH range has to be between 3 and 4. 3.5 in the MCAT will be close enough, and then we do 14 minus 3.5, which is our pOH, and that gives us an answer of 10.5 for our pH. Punching this example into the calculator gave me an answer of 10.36, which on the MCAT is close enough. Be sure to join me in the next video where I show you a similar shortcut for how to solve anti-logs for when you're given a pH, pOH, or pKa and have to find the concentration or the Ka value.
MCATExamStrategy.com